Welcome to the Ecliptic Spiritualist channel. I'm Ronnita, and it is the last day of March. It is Tuesday to us, C-H-O-O-S-E. It is the 31st, and we are at this end of the month, right? So what is three words that you would describe March? Three words to describe March to you. You can comment down below, and I would like to have each and every one of us to set one intention going into April, which is tomorrow. Set one intention, what you want to set for yourself as an intention for April, okay? So, in saying that, let's get it in. We have the King of Pentacles as our card for today. And as our clarifier, we have the Queen in reverse, the Queen of Cups in reverse. I've got a little bit of tropical music going on because in my mind, I'm at the beach. I'm ready, but I don't know how the earth is doing. You know, she's getting her nurturing, getting back to balance. So we'll see those things as we're getting back to balance and allowing us to go through this time of what it is, you know. So with the King of Pentacles here, yes, it is time to trust the finances and to know that you have a capability and ability to keep the love connections are here. So there's a twofold of things going on. There is trusting your finances. Yes, it's time to trust your finances. And the ability to keep the love connections are very strong right now, okay? So we've got a lot of that, okay? So with the Queen of Cups in reverse, you have this other side of you that is concerned about what others think. Let that go. Let that go, please. You know, don't worry about that. Let it go. Trust what you're doing. You have a twofold finances, trust your finances, and trust the ability for love connections right now. So that you're feeling about love connections is very real. So let your energy flow and be acceptable in that area, okay? It's all good. Go on and trust it, all right? We do have the astrological forecast that is up on the blog. You can check our website at https://eclipticspiritualist7.com, and the astrological forecast is up. But we do have Venus and Jupiter right now, so it's bringing a vibe of love and expansion in a lot of areas. So you're going to see a lot of things that are expanding because Jupiter is in play, and we do have Capricorn and some other energies that is going to, and Aquarius as well, that's going to make things look more expanded. But in reality, it already had been there anyway. It's not, and I'm talking about some things that are political and things that are going on in our world today that is going to look like things are at a height. But in actuality, it was there all along. It's just getting some clarity in some areas. And you also are getting clarity in some areas. So trust that and set yourself up for next month, which is tomorrow, with setting an intention for that, so that you're going into the month ready and trusting your intuition. And that's what the readings are all about each day as well. It is a general reading, so it may or may not resonate with you, but if you follow throughout the week, you will see that they all do connect. Okay, if you are interested in an intuitive reading one-on-one, you're more than welcome. They will change your life about your past, present, and future, about yourself, about family, and much, much more. Things that you would like to know to come, you know, because we can orchestrate our life and get off the figure eight of the same thing, getting the same results. You got to do something different to get a different result. No matter what things are looking like in the world, you are ultimately in charge of your own destiny. And it is your mindset that will change your life and where you are. Okay. So, in saying that, click that wiggly bell down below, ding dong ding, to make sure you're getting the daily fresh tarot card reading that comes to you on a daily basis. We offer intuitive readings that will change your life, that are diagnostic consultations. We offer ritual work, which is spell work that will change your life in every single area. We do have this Friday our first of the month Saints Blessing Vigil. We are working with a particular saint along with the other combinations that I've been putting together with Saint Roch, R-O-C-H. You're more than welcome to look him up. That deals with plagues and health and things that we are currently going through worldwide. Whether if you are experiencing any kind of health challenges, or we see that the world is, you can still burn a candle. It will be burned every single day, a tea light for 7 days. And it's $7.77 to cover yourself and your family and to bring in this flow of energetic blessings and covering in our health and spirit and abundance and so much more. We should always go into the month set up. I do it each first Friday of the month. Last month we skipped it because we had so much energy going on in the beginning of the month that I was guided to not do that. But this is a very important, so jump right in. Don't be afraid or holding on to your abundance or your money, because you should always be circulating your money no matter what. And that is putting it back into your life. That's what it is. The vigils are putting it back into who you are. Not me. It's a community unity effort. And that's what a lot of this transition in the worldwide in the earth is all about, community and unity. And we must recognize those things. And then we will come back much stronger as a community collectively. We do have a couple of things going on. We have our book club, which is Flowers in the Attic. We have our second official Zoom chat live tomorrow night, April the 1st at 7:30 Eastern Standard Time. It is in the phone numbers, and how to connect with video and live chat is in the description box down below. Also, too, that's going to be wonderful tomorrow. We're working on Hekate still. That's the book. We're going to be sharing and chatting on that. I'm going to just step away, so please forgive me. This is the book. I'm just doing a couple of PSAs. If you don't mind, stick with it. This is the book that we're going over still, that we were started off on. So if you just had got that book, you're more than welcome to join in. This is the new book that we are dealing with now, that we're preparing for May to be our chat on. So go on and get this book. This is The Dark Goddess, Journey to the Dark Goddess. Okay, as you can see, I have a lot of books I always reading. So by Jane Meredith, this is the new book. So go on and do that. It's imperative to dig deep in your spiritual life. Also, we have Today is Sacred 2020. That's part of our Patreon account, along with our book club as well. That's like a small spiritual school. If the divine was sharing, he said, Ronnita, it's a school. But it is a small spiritual school that we're doing. I'm doing several times a week, prompts to help you guide through your own sacred and magical practice as a practitioner. And it will be building your sacred space, building your energy and learning and so much more, with a small nominal donation, whatever, of your choice. I don't have a tier levels built there. I just know that it's going to be doing a lot. It's a small spiritual school, and it deals with so many aspects. Just give you a little tidbit. I won't be long. The other day I posted about crystal grids. Yesterday morning was about an overview of March and getting you to write down prompts and things that, how to get you to think through spiritual things. So it's a small school. And I have been telling you we were going to launch for it into April. I told you to get your running shoes because you're going to be speeding up. So if you're interested in building your spiritual life, it's a great way to join Patreon, because you'll be getting several different instructional things a week. You know, we're going to be doing some meditation, some sacred circles, just trying to set that energy up for us. It's already set up for me, already written for the year, but I'm encouraging each and every one of you to do that, so that you are built up in this world and spiritually, so you're not left behind without knowledge. And all things, get knowledge, get understanding, get the word of truth. Because when you're diving within yourself, the spirit guides and angels and your higher self will be able to work with that. So in saying that, I love each and every one of you. Have a great Tuesday. See you next time. Bye-bye.